From 1974, we began to see the removal of this original truth from the church. When devil came into Nigeria with foreign gospel, the gospel of prosperity that turned the labor into business, that turned the labor into profit-oriented ventures. And what do they have? They only have hirelings, the vamparblasts, the orators, the motivational speakers, who are not laborers. Now, do you hear that what he said? Verse 29. To this end, I also labor. I labor to get this result. To this end, to make man perfect, I labor, striving according to his work, which works in me. I said, Jesus needs laborer. He needs help. He needs to get laborers in his vineyard. Not only that, let's look at another scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, from verse 8 to 9. Now, he who plants and he who waters are one. In the process, you may sing, I may preach. But all our labor is reconciling man back to God. And every man shall receive his own reward according to what? His own labor. For we are laborers. Today, the language laborers is no longer in the church. We don't have laborers any longer. We are laborers together with God. You are God's husband. I fellow labor in me. You are the husband of God. We want to labor over you. You are God's building. We want to labor and build you up. We don't break ground. Jesus needs laborers. Jesus needs laborers. He needs laborers. Can we just get the scripture? The book of Matthew chapter 9, verse 37. Then he said to his disciple, the harvest truly is plentiful, but what is few? Till today, laborers are few. If Nigeria can have 100 laborers and they work in 3 years to produce 10 other laborers, within 10 years, this country will be a righteous country. But we are the laborers. Many Jehovah say, I don't understand even what I'm talking about. They only take the scripture to suit themselves. Many pastors have bastardized the gospel. He will soon say it. The percentage of laborer is so small, so minute. Those who labor. And don't forget, one thing that devil is doing now is to make the work of the laborers to be foolishness to the crowd. That's why when Jesus began to labor over his disciples in John chapter 6 verse 16, that some of his disciples said, Daddy, this teaching is too hard. They left him. The Bible says these hard ones, they will speak evil of the gospel. Verse 38 now says, therefore pray the Lord of harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Today we have many workers in the church, but few laborers. So fortunately, you will see this church, we ordain 1,000 pastors. This church, we ordain 10,000 pastors. God is angry and is not happy, because whom you are ordaining as this prophet, as this pastor, they are serving the devil. They are workers of iniquities. They were not labored over. They don't know how to labor. One quietly is a mechanic. You need to go under a professional mechanic that is working. You can see testimony, you can see evidence. That's why 1 John chapter 1 verse 1 says, that which we have heard, we have seen, we have looked upon, and our hands have touched. A laborer has it in his hand. The place you are that is strange to you is common to him. He has passed through the place you are still agitating. The question that is affecting you is a common thing to him. He also passed through the stage. Why was it easier for Joshua to lead the people to the land of Canaan. He had been to the place. He was there ahead of them. So it was easier for him to carry them there. He has been to Canaan. He was one of the 12 spies that went there. He has seen how it's the place look like. Many workers for few laborers. Jesus needs laborers. It's unfortunate today. Laborers is less than 5% in the church. Less than 5%. The laborers, 1 Corinthians 3:9, Galatians 4:1 to 19, you can read it here. Colossians chapter 1, 26 to 29. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14 to 17. Laborers, let's read this. Laborers are those who make you to walk with God. They make you to walk. They are laborers. They present you behind Jesus so that you follow Christ. You follow Christ. Galatians chapter 4. I'm reading verse 1 and 2. But I say that as long as the Son, do you hear the word here now? Some version call it here. He's the Son. The kingdom recognized Son. You may say you are a servant of God. A son of God is far, 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 far above you in the kingdom. As long as the Son is a child, not tutor, not oriented. He has given his life to Jesus, but he's still a child. He's still a baby. It's not about child. It's not about small boy, small girl. But child in faith, child in knowledge, child in understanding. As long as the Son is a child, he's no way different from a servant. To be treated as a servant. He can be tossed to and fro. Any prophet can fake things on him. Though he is the Lord of all, I told you, Son takes dominion. Son is a Lord. But you see that it's a small Lord here. Not capital Lord. But he's a form of God. Verse 2 now says, but he's under keepers, under managers, under tutors, there are different versions, under governors, under administrator, under discipler, under pastor, under laborer. These are the set. He will be under. We must be put. Pastoring should be a discipleship adventure. But today is different. Laborers are few. Till the time fixed by the Father, you don't just come out of laborer. Laborer that cannot just leave you. There is a signal, a network between the master. Don't forget, he said we are all laborers with God. God is the chief laborer. Then we are the human agent laboring. And you, there is a connection between the three of us. So if the Father is now releasing, giving the signal, I should release you. I remember when he led me to be under my own discipler. I thought within 1 year I would be there. But it is the time appointed by the Father. None of us have. I remember several times now that we say, I have an opportunity for you somewhere. No, sir. The Father that said I should come here have not given me a signal. There must be a signal. There must be a signal. There must be is the Father's mind. Is the Father's mind to speak, to talk about your growth. When you are true, when you are done. Then, I thought within 1 year, but I was there for almost 9 years. But when the appointed time came, I heard it from God that it is time. And by the time I came home, my wife said, my dad said, I should come and see him. And when we got there, I said, God said I should release you. Because it is the feast time. It is the time appointed by the Father. It is the time appointed by the Father. Jesus needs laborers, unfortunately. Instead of laborers, what do we have today? We have peddlers. We have what? Peddlers. We have peddlers. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 3. Second Corinthians chapter 2 verse, we have peddlers. Peddlers. This slide, okay? Now, who are the peddlers? Who are the peddlers? Second Peter 2:3. In their greed, they will make up clever lies to get hold of your money. They are peddlers. Or not jalawa. That is where I'm going. But God condemned them long ago, and their destruction will not be delayed. But Katowa destroyed, they have destroyed many people's life. They are peddlers. They are peddlers. Second Corinthians chapter 2, verse 17. You see, we are not like many oxlers. I want banjo, peddlers who preach for personal profits. Today we are peddlers. They have a very sweet mouth. They are motivational speakers. Our itching ear want to listen to what they want to say, because they look for the part of the scripture that suits you. They look for the part of the scripture that will entice you. They tell you about the positive things alone. They make you to shout. They make you to scream. This generation, that is what they know as glory of God in the church. Unfortunately, God is crying over their lives because they are under pettiness. Those who, by the time they are talking, you are coming to drop money. You are coming to drop the peddlers. The Bible says from that 2 Peter 2:3, they will make up clever lies to get hold. Clever lies to get hold of your money. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 3. They will make up. They will make up. They will think about what they will use to cajole you. They will give you rudiment of financial prosperity. Simple thing Jesus Christ said, seek ye first the kingdom. That prosperity they are teaching you will be added. I'm a typical example. Will be added. You need to just understand the biblical principle. And unfortunately today, they peddle the gospel. So they said that you sow everything you have and there is nothing that comes out of it. Now, these are the set of people instead of being outside of laborer. Set number one, peddlers. Set number two, they are hirelings. Hirelings. Alagbashe ni won da won ni. Ogota ogota. Owo alaru ape. John chapter 10 verse 12 to 13. But a hireling, he who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leave the sheep and flees, and the wolf catches the sheep and scatter them. Verse 13, the hireling flees because he is a hireling. One hireling. They are after salary, they are after wages, they are earners. Such set of people, they will be looking for cathedrals. They are hirelings. They cannot labor. They cannot make three congregations to be great because they are not laborers. We have millions of them in their churches, different branches. Sir, they are not laborers. They are working for wages. They are working for salaries. So they want us to sweet places, bigger places. We are yes, they will just call them, sir, I'm facing a challenge. I'm sorry, they cannot come. They will come and meet you because you are facing challenge. They will dodge you. They don't like poor people in their church. They don't want to see sick people. They cannot labor. That's why you see some people say, I don't say this okay, mini cunny. No, laborers will never say that. Laborers will never say that. But it's unfortunate that we have higher means. They are too much in a generation. They are heinous. They are after wages. They are after pay. If they come to greet you in their house, in your house, they will be people telling you, Emma Shenila Lejo. They will be telling you, pay washer on that. They after pay. They don't labor over lives. They want their prayer on the mountain. Oluwa dari awon olowo wa sinu jo mi. They cannot make you to be rich. They are only looking for ready made. They are hirelings. They are not laborers. Can you guess thousands of people we have in this category. Jesus needs help. The third one, they are consumers. Awon yeye to say ayalin o sise ni won won aya won ni, you understand? They employ them and they see themselves as workers waiting for month end to collect salary, that the members of the church will come and bring something. Baba dope wa, even if you are not giving it, they will tell you the essence of visiting you in your place of work is not for them to see your well-being, it's for them to take from you. But consumers are like that. But this consumer, they have their own place as a shop. I want to join ministry here, but they are consumers in that place. Brethren, oh God, you know, Paul cried here, Philippians chapter 3, verse 17. He cried here, he said, brethren, join in following my example, please. Leaders stick poor, workers stick poor, but follow my example and know those who so walk in that my example. Because the truth is one, when you see a laborer in an Anglican church, it's the same attitude of a laborer in a deeper life. If you see a laborer has only one goal, reconciling men back to God. They are not working for the denomination they have. They are working for the kingdom of God. This is a feature of all of them. So if you see them in any denomination they have, they are not working for denomination. They work for the kingdom because they are laborers of the Father. But consumers are not like that. For many work, of whom I have told you often, and now telling you, even weeping, also honestly, because I want consumer enough, because they entice them. They use magical power to lure them. They use different things, planned miracles to tell them lies so that they feed them. Even some, they are using charm to make them to sit down, to collect from them. There is something they call associate in this generation. The pastor will tell you, go and bring 100,000, and you will discover that you will be restless until you get that 100,000 for him. They are consumers. That's why Paul was crying there. He said, I am weeping that they are the enemy of the cross of Christ. They only come out. They are not after God, my Jesus. They are consumers. Verse 19, he said, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly. If you alone dictate the type of preaching they will tell to you, they will teach you. All their teaching, that's why they can curse you. If you don't pay your tithe, things will tithe for you. That's why they curse you with your offering. But it's sovereignty, oh son. That's why they curse, because their belly is their God. And their glory is in their shame. What do they call glory these days? Earthly things. They set their mind on earthly things. Jeremy, my Lincoln Navigator, they are consumers. You see one pastor boasting on television, yes, by the time I clock 50, I will be riding my 58th Jeep. Now I have 48. Of what? Is that the glory? But that is the confusion. Everyone is weeping because we don't have laborers again. We have hirelings. Number four, we have extortioners. Yes, a lot of people we know them now. Extortioners are very close to us. Extortioners, the Bible says, all the extortioners, they will have their portion in hellfire. Extortioners are the set of people that will be telling you, yes, I need 20 people that will give me 10,000. Now they are extortioners. 10,000. Yes, I will pray for you. I'll pour this anointing on you. They are extortioners. They are fundraisers. They collect, and after raising it, they collect their 30% from the owner of the church. And that is how they are milking the sheep of God. God is sad over this set of people. And today we have them in mass. most of our prophets now, most of our evangelists, let them organize a crusade, it's extortioning. So even make other call, no problem, no money call. They have 3 hours to do program, they will soon use 2.5 hours to call for money. From 10,000, 5,000, for 5,000, 1,000, even to 50 naira. Stupidity. Wickedness. The Bible called them enemy of the cross. They are enemy of the cross. It's so painful. They are not laborers. They are extortioners. They are extortioners. They are robbers in the name of Christ. They are robbers. Only anyone you call you, I want to call you a jale. And you call you a jale. Ijokoe, Oluwale, Thomas Jokole, now, Oma Adbe Jide, Koto Jokole, Mutu 2000, Oya 2000, 2000, 2000. The Bible says their judgment is not holding. They are doomed already. They are sons of perdition because they are enemy of the cross. They are not laborers, extortioners. We have marketers. They will market prayer for you. Before you pray this prayer, you must drop 1,000. They market water for you. They call pure water. They can say 20,000. They can say 10,000. They get oil. I am here. I'm seeing Corona oil now. They are selling it 100,000. Corona oil. They are marketers. 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 14. We are not among those who meddle the gospel. And if you see what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 10, verse 8, he said, freely you have received, freely give. Any church you get to, and they sell water for you. They sell anything for you. Anything, I repeat. That they said, this thing we are selling for you, we give you miracle. They sell calendar that worth 20 naira, or sticker that worth 20 naira, they sell it for 200 naira. They are extortioners. They are doomed by the cross. Anyone? They are enemies of the cross. They are not laboring one. They can only get a standard. You cannot call Jesus. They will tell you many evil things happen. The next one, they are dealers. That's the last one. They are dealers. I want to know Puruju. Dealers. Hey! You know, dealers can labor for 10 years to get these results. They are dealers. We read it from that 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 1 to 3. You understand? Okay. Worse, they are worse in shepherd's clothing. I've seen Alaji that founded a church at Olosun in Ibadan. Thank God can't close that church down. They want business center. They are wolves. Today we see many babalawos coming to start church. Today you see them going to occultism, taking magical powers and starting church. No, the Bible has prophesied that it's going to happen. There are set of people that are injuring the body of Christ. Jeremiah chapter 29, 9 to 28. You will read, just write it down. Ezekiel chapter 34, 1 to 16. You will see their description there. God said they prophesy in my name, but I did not send them. They will tell you it is well when it is not well for themselves. They prophesy lies. They tell you fake things. They come on a global tech network to predict what will never come to pass. Notice me prophecy. It's unfortunate that these are the people we have. From peddler to hirelings, from hirelings to consumers, to extortioners, to dealers, we have close to 95% of ministers of the gospel in this category. But we have less than 5% here. You can see this. Any pastor you see, tell me how many laborers you see. How many peddlers you see? How many hirelings you see? How many consumers you see? The pastors you know, they are either here. How many do you see that labor, that spend and spending their own life, that they can lay their life down because they work for the kingdom. Who are not after salary, who are not after monetary gains. You can't understand if you don't understand the scripture. I pray God will help us in the name of Jesus. About these robbers, these wolves, we have the prophecy in the scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 13 to 15. For such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into apostles of Christ, and no marvels. For Satan himself is transformed into angel of light. Therefore, it is not great thing if his minister also be transformed as minister of righteousness. That's why they clamor righteousness. Just confess righteousness. They don't do labor. They only say confess righteousness and everything. Hey, excuse me. Yes, I have Christ. Yes, I'll be bringing your materials. That's what they are doing. And a lot of people that doesn't want their old man to die before, they fill the place. The Bible says the time is coming that people will not hear sound doctrine. They don't want to follow laborers. What laborer does is injurious to our old man. And the spirit and the flesh, they are enemies. So that's why in the church of a laborer, you can hardly see 100 people. He can labor for 20 years and all the congregation can just be only 100. Only 100. But let me tell you, let an hireling come. Let a peddler come. Who will be so vocal? The orators with quotable quotes just begin to brag, vain babblings. Then you see, hey. You can come as you are, just dress anyhow. They don't deal with the old man, nothing concerns them with breaking down the nature of sin in you. No! They are peddlers. The Bible says they will appear as minister of righteousness. Minister of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. 1 Timothy chapter 4. Now the Spirit speaks expressly. Hey, he begs us. He knows that what this generation is going to face in so-called ministers of God will be doomed, and we are in it already. If your life is not void of sin, you are under a wrong leadership. You have given your life to Jesus Christ for more than 5 years and sin is still in you. I'm telling you, listen carefully. You are under wrong leadership. Because by the time of 5 years, you must see the progress. And after all, yes, the old man must die. Then that means he doesn't do anything over your life. He doesn't labor at all. 5 years and the sin is still there. The nature of sin is still there. And you don't have condemnation for that sin. Somebody preach. You are dropping money, dropping your wristwatch, dropping your phone. Another person preach. You go home and you drop all your charms. You will cry. The one that preach and you are dropping charms, you are laying down all your weapons, all your evil things, he will not collect money because he won't give you money. Those are the laborers. The one that make you to see sin as sin. But your own, does it make you to see sin as sin? Or is glorifying sin in your life? So that your ego is blessing him the more. Yes, we transfer money to my account. Some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirit and doctrine, teaching of the devil, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience shared with hot iron. This is what is called apostasy, joining the gospel of Satan to kick out the truth, to decline from faith. Satan is not fighting church, he's only joining them. He does more harm by sowing tears than by pulling up wheat. He accomplishes more by imitation than by outright opposition. I want you to see this passion. From the third episode, we will look at the havoc that the church has done for Jesus and his mandate. We will see the havoc and we will see the way out. We have just 3 sections. God help us with first episode yesterday. We are concluding the second episode here. And we shall be looking tomorrow into the third episode. Please, I want us to reason. Who am I working for? Jesus or Satan? You can be a pastor working for Satan. Jesus can tell you on that day, I never knew you are a worker of Satan. You are a worker of iniquity. If your labor does not, your assignment does not correlate with the labor in his heart, you are only fooling yourself. Your life must reflect him, and his life must reflect back in you. Shall we? I want us to close our eyes and talk to God. Lord, interpret this to me. The truth is scarce in our generation. It's very, 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 very scarce. But it's still available. Laborers are very few. We have noisemakers everywhere. Go on our DSTV, go on messages, you see people. And when you even see the so-called ministers these days, the generation of worldly ministers, the old man and portrait, old man, you know, they watch on the stage, they will preach. The look of Jezebel, you know, if he preach. The attitude and the pride of Satan, you know, if he preach. Arrogance of Satan, you know, if he preach. You are dead and you look at their ear cut and we cry. Jesus Christ said, do not conform to the pattern of the world. Now, our son to the world. Our ministers, they dress like the world. Our choir, they minister like the world. God is sad. Jesus need help. Can you rise up to help him? Say, God, I need personal interpretation of this. I need personal encounter. I need personal revelation. Only one life, the money. I must not get to heaven before I know the truth. Not everybody has said, Lord, Lord, we make heaven. God, if I am under a wrong leader, lead me to a laborer who will walk over my life. Many of you are the one leading your pastor. It's not the one leading you. Because I am leading, whatever Nico Shalom has said, a laborer can chase you out if you are not complying. Get out. A laborer will labor to make sure that you become Christ. He will drill you. He will sit upon you. He will brood upon you. Seriously. This will be called Salon. Yes. If truly you are willing and obedient, you will become it. If I wish you to roll, you cannot have a cake. You can't call it a cake until it passes through oven. The laborers are the oven of God. The laborers are the oven. But we are there. We are there. What we have today is pastor that will preach you what your itching ear want to hear. Ah, we don't want to lose our youth. So let them come as they are. Let us give them what they want. Hey, you are the one controlling your pastor? Hey, unfortunate. These are unfortunate generation. Millions of workers, few laborers. Millions of crowd in the church, but only few saints. Only saints will make heaven. Talk to God. Lord, you will help me to understand. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Lord, I pray for my viewers and listeners, wherever you are. I pray the seed of this word will germinate and make the effectiveness of this truth a reality in everyone's life. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, let your word come with all simplicity and give revelation to what I have said. In the mighty name of Jesus. As I will be concluding it tomorrow, Father, we pray that your word will come, Jesus, with that great power, the potency of transformation to make us sons indeed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' precious name, we pray. May the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, fellowship of Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore.
I believe you have been blessed by that word of life, the moment of truth. Jesus Christ came to pay the price. You will know the truth, and the truth will make you free. It is what you do with what you hear that produces results. Remember the parable of the sower. Let this word go to a fertile ground in your heart, so that it can produce fruits that will abide for eternal rest. God bless you. I remain yours, Unction Timothy Olufemi. This message is a series, an episode. Don't miss the next episode, and don't miss the next series. Do me a favor by subscribing on this page, so that the other episode can be a blessing to you as well. God bless you.